Hi everyone, in this video I am going to explain the chemistry bits which are given in the NTSC 2021 paper, the stage 1 paper which is conducted by the government of Andhra Pradesh. This video will be very useful for the students who are going to appear for the NTSC examination this year and for the 9th class students who are going to write the NTSC examination in the following year. So let us go through the video. See the first bit, which is based on the colloids and the dispersed phase and medium present in the colloids, which is from the 9th class standard. The first one is gemstone. We know that gemstone is from solid and solid. So first one matches with C. And in the shaving cream, the dispersed phase and dispersed medium are gas and liquid. So shaving cream is a gas in liquid. So second one matches with D. Cheese is a liquid in solid colloid. So third one matches with B. And a cloud is a liquid in gas. So fourth one matches with A. So that is the option 1 is the right answer. First one, gemstone is C. Second one, shaving cream is D. And cheese is liquid in solid B. And a cloud is a liquid in gas. So the option 1 is the right answer for this bit, which is from the 9th class standard bit. Next one, the mass of 3.011 into 10 to the power of 23 molecules of nitrogen atom is, so this is also from the 9th class standard bit, which is from the mole concept. We know that the nitrogen atom weighs 14 grams. In the 14 grams of nitrogen, there are Avogadro number of molecules, that is 6. Avogadro number of atoms, that is 6.022 into 10 to the power of 23 atoms will be present in the 14 grams of nitrogen. But here the number of atoms are given as 3.011 into 10 to the power of 23, which is half of this one. So when the number of atoms becomes half, the weight also becomes half. So the weight will be 7 grams. So the option 3 is the right answer for the 15th bit. And for the 16th question, the 4 quantum numbers of the 19th electron of potassium is. So the potassium atomic number is 19. The electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6 and 4s1. That is the 19th electron is in the 4s1 state. So we have to write the 4 quantum numbers for this 4s1 orbital. So now let us write 4 quantum numbers for 4s1. So n value is 4, okay. For s orbital, l value is 0. When l value is 0, magnetic quantum number also will be equal to 0. And spin quantum number cannot be equal to 0. So the spin quantum number is plus half. So number 2 is the correct set of 4 quantum numbers for the lost electron of potassium. So that is the right answer. It is from the quantum numbers concept, which is in 10th class standard. So 17th question, in the reaction 2PbO plus C gives rise to 2Pb plus CO2, the 4 options are given. We have to guess the correct statements in the 4 given options. So when you cleanly observe the reaction, it is a redox reaction. That means one will be oxidized, the other will be reduced. That is a oxidation reduction reaction. So when we carefully observe the reaction, here the carbon without any oxygen, but after completion of the reaction, it contains 2 oxygens. That is, addition of oxygen takes place for the carbon. So addition of oxygen is called as oxidation. So carbon is oxidized in that reaction. And when you observe the lead oxide, there is an oxygen beside lead here, but after completion of the reaction, there is no oxygen beside the lead. That is, the removal of oxygen takes place here. That is, lead oxide is reduced. So lead oxide is reduced and carbon is oxidized. So 2 and 4 are the right options, which are present in the 4th choice. So option 4 is the right answer for the 17th bit. So next bit is based on assertion and reasoning. Elements and compounds are the examples for the pure substances. As right answer, pure substances are two types, elements and compounds. And the next, the reason is the properties of compounds are different from those of the elements. That is also right. Elements have different properties and the compounds which are formed from these elements have the different properties. So both assertion is true, reason is also true, but this reason is not supporting the assertion. There is no link between the assertion and the reason here. So the answer will be both A and R are true, but R is not the correct explanation of A. Next, 19th question. It is based on the elements and their symbols from the 10th class standard. Curium, the symbol is Cm. Okay. Fermium symbol is Fm. Nobelium symbol is NO. And mandelivium symbol is MD. So the option 2 is the right answer. Very, very straightforward question, but we have to know all the elements and their symbols to answer that question. Next, 20th question is from the 9th class standard, which is from the Rutherford gold foil experiment. Assertion and reason are the assertion reason type of question this is. In the experiment of alpha particle scattering experiment, gold foil is preferred. As it is right, assertion is right, gold foil is preferred. Reason, gold is a ductile material. As the reason is also correct, gold is a ductile material. You know, ductility means formation of voids. Ductility means formation of voids. Okay, but here in the gold foil experiment, we don't need any voids, we need a thin foil. That means we need malleability, not ductility. So both are correct, but the reason is not correct. So both A and R are true, but R is not the correct explanation of A here. So the 20th answer is 2. Next one. The ratio of rate of diffusion of two gases X and Y is 16:1. When these two gases are combined, it gives a liquid which is very essential for the survival of living beings on the earth. The two gases are respectively. So when you observe the question, the liquid is very essential for the living beings on the earth, that is water. The liquid which is essential for us and for all the living organisms is nothing but water. We know that water contains hydrogen and oxygen, so the option 2 is the right answer. But very, very straightforward question, direct question. And 22nd one is based on mole concept again. So mole concept is very important concept for NTSA examination. So please go thoroughly through the mole concept and practice more and more questions in the mole concept for the better result in the NTSA examinations. When 4 grams of carbon is completely burnt, the volume occupied by the liberated gas at STP is. So the equation belongs to the given question is, when carbon is completely burned in air, it forms carbon dioxide. So here this carbon dioxide volume will be 22.4 liters when the carbon weighs 12 grams, because we know that the atomic weight of carbon is 12 grams. Because when 1 mole of carbon reacts with 1 mole of oxygen, here the 1 mole of carbon dioxide is released. When 1 mole of gas releases, it always occupies 22.4 liters. That means 22.4 liters of gas is released when 12 grams of carbon is participated in the reaction. But the question is here, 4 grams of carbon gives how much volume of gas? So for this one, once I have solved this one, see here, the 12 grams of carbon gives us 22.4 liters of carbon dioxide. 4 grams of carbon gives how much? Let it be X. Okay, so to solve this one, we have to do the following procedure. That is 12 by 4, this one divided by this one is equal to this one divided by this one. So 12 by 4 is equal to 22.4 by X. So that gives us X is equal to 22.4 into this 4 comes here and the 12 goes here, 4 by 12. This 4 cancel here 3 times. When 22.4 is divided by 3, we get nearly 21. So 0.14, 3 times 12, that is nearly 7.46 liters. So that will be the answer for that question. So this is also based on mole concept. If you cannot understand my explanation here, that means you have to develop your concept on the mole concept, which is very very useful for your all examinations, and also the stoichiometry chapter in the intermediate is completely based on this mole concept. So the answer is 7.46. Next one, the number of valency electrons present in the outermost cells of the atoms of sodium, copper and germanium respectively, which is from the 10th class standard periodicity of the elements, the modern periodic table. So sodium, we know that the electronic configuration of sodium is 2, 8, 1, so number of valency electrons is 1. And for copper the atomic number is 29, and the electronic configuration will be like this: 2, 8, 18, 2. So if you are not able to understand this one, I will write the complete electronic configurations. For sodium, the electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s1. There is a valency shell and the number of electrons in the valency shell is 1. So for sodium, the valency electrons is 1. And for copper, the atomic number is 29, electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6. 4s2, actually the electronic configuration is 4s1, 3d10. So the valency electrons will be equal to 1, because 4s is the last cell, which is the valency cell. Okay, so the number of valency electrons for the copper is also equal to 1, or in some cases the electronic configuration will be 4s2, 3d9. So the number of valency electrons will be equal to 2. So there is no option contains 1 for the copper, so let us take 2 as the valency electrons for the copper. And for germanium atomic number is 32, the electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s2, 3d10 and 4p2. This is the electronic configuration of germanium with atomic number 32. So the 4s and 4p are the valency orbitals. Valency cell is the fourth cell. So total number of valency electrons is, in s there are 2 electrons and in p there are 2 electrons. Totally there are 4 electrons in the fourth cell of germanium. So 4 is the right answer. So option 3 is the right answer, 1, 2 and 4. So let us see the next question. Indicators are weak acids and weak bases. So they may be weak acids or they may be weak acids. So option 1 is the right one. Strong acids or strong bases, it is not the right option. They help to find the acidic and basic natures of liquids. Yes, it's perfectly true. Why we use indicators is to find which is acidic and which is basic solutions. So, and the fourth one, most of them are organic compounds. Yes, the fourth one is also true. Most indicators are organic compounds, because we know that litmus is obtained from a plant, which is an organic compound. The turmeric, what we use as a natural indicator, is also an organic compound. So generally most of them are organic compounds. So 1, 3, 4 are the correct statements for the given question. So where is that option? 1, 3, 4 is in second one. Next, 25th question. Copper present in 50 grams of CuSO4 is. So again the mole concept is given here, that is maybe just related to the mole concept, but this is related to the atomic weight concept. Atomic weight and molecular weight concept is asked here. Copper present in 50 grams of CuSO4. So for this question, we have to calculate the molecular weight of CuSO4. So to calculate the molecular weight of any compound, first we have to know the atomic weights of the individual elements. So we have to know the atomic weight of copper, we have to know the atomic weight of sulfur, we have to know the atomic weight of oxygen. By using all these values, we can calculate the molecular weight of copper sulfate. So I have already solved this one for you. So let us go through that one. So molecular weight of CuSO4 is, there are one copper here, copper weight is 63.5, so 1 into 63.5 is 63.5. there is one sulfur here, the atomic weight of sulfur is 32, so 1 into 32 is 32. There are four oxygens here though, so atomic weight of oxygen is 16, so 4 16s are 64. So when we add all these atomic weights, we get the molecular weight of CuSO4. The molecular weight of CuSO4 is 159.5. So 63.5 grams of copper present in 159.5. So what this value says is, 159.5 grams of copper sulfate contains 63.5 grams of copper. So I wrote here 63.5 grams copper present in 159.5 grams of copper sulfate. So in 50 grams of copper sulfate, how much copper will be present? That it will be X. So as usual, how to solve this one? This one divided by this one is equal to this one divided by this one. So 63.5 divided by X is equal to 159.5 divided by 50. So X is equal to 63.5, this 50 will come up here and this 159 will go down and this X will go here. So X is equal to 63.5 into 50 by 159.5. We have to know how to interchange these terms from left hand side of the equation to the right hand side, that you have to practice well. So now when you do the calculation, when we do the multiplication in the numerator, we get 3175 divided by 159.5. So by dividing 3175 by 195.5, I got nearly 19.9. So the answer will be 19.9 grams. So where is the option here? The 19.90 grams of copper is present in 50 grams of copper sulfate. Next question, which of the following are the correct in respect of silver metal? So we know that silver is good malleable and ductile, and it is a good electric conductor, and the melting point of silver is 690 degrees Celsius. So all are correct options. So the option 4 is the right for this question. So the chemistry part is completed in this paper. I hope you all understood my explanation. If you like my video, please share and subscribe my video, and please prepare well for the NTSC examination, which will be very, very useful for your future and also for your placements in the government as well as in private jobs also. It is very, very useful examination for all the students. Thank you.